Launch Advanced Design application from Start menu or using the shortcut placed on the desktop. Choose to start a new Advanced Design document. Once the new project is created, click Next in the window of the project title dialog box to access the following window, where you can define the structural assumption. Select the workspace type by selecting Plane Radio Bottom. Select the Bending Rigid Structure option. In the material list, select the S235 Steel. To define the default cross-section for your structure, click this button to access the Cross-Section Library dialog box. From Grated Profile list, select the UK Universal Beam Library. In the cross-section list, select the UKB 254x146x37 section and click OK to apply and exit. By clicking Modify, you have access to the Units dialog box. Click Finish to close the Project Setting dialog box. To draw the first column, access Create a Linear Element command in the Home toolbar in the Linear and Plate section. In the Linear Elements property window, go to Cross-Section category, click Extremity 1 cell, and select the Cross-Section Library. From the Grated Product UK Universal Beam Library, select the UKB 406x178x67 cross-section. Click OK to apply and close the window. Once you have defined the property, draw a linear element with a length of 6 m using one of the following methods. Draw the element using the snap on the work plane. You can guide by the coordinates displayed on the upper left side of the drawing area. Enter the element coordinates in the command line, 0,0 for the first extremity and 0,6 for the second. To create the second column, select the linear element and click the copy button from the CAD function toolbar. The translation copy mode must be selected and the rotation must be disabled. Select the translation defined by an increment vector. Enter the vector field in X, Y, Z coordinates, separated by spaces, 16, 0, 0. Enter the number of copied element in the number field, 1. Click Preview to view the result and confirm the action by clicking Copy. Click Close to exit this window. To draw the two rafter, access Create a Linear Element command. In the Linear Elements Properties window, go to Cross-Section category. Click Extremity 1 cell and then click the drop-down list and select the UKB 254x146x37 cross-section. Draw the element using the automatic snap move. Place the rafter's first extremity on the top of the first column. Enter the coordinates of the second extremity in the command line, 8,8, and then press Enter. Draw the second rafter, snapping between the end of the first rafter and the top of the second column. Access the Rigid Point Support Drawing Tool. Click Rigid Support from Supports in the Home toolbar. In the Supports property window, select the Pinned Restraint type. Create the supports by a simple click at each column base. Now we generate the load. First, we generate the self-weight. In the pilot, select Loading, right-click and select from the context menu Create a Case Family. A dialog box is displayed. Select the Dead Loads Family, then click OK. Dead Loads Family and the Dead Load Case are available in the pilot. The dead load is automatically generated on the vertical axis for the entire structure. We generate then the linear loads. In the pilot, select Loading, right-click and choose from the context menu Create a Case Family. A dialog box is displayed. Select the Load Family type Live Loads and then click OK. The Live Loads family and the load case automatically generated, named Q by default, are available in the pilot. Select Linear Load from the Load and then in Load Case toolbar. In the Linear Loads property window, go to Definition field and enter the F dead value, -50 kN. creates the two linear loads between the extremities of each rafter, using the snap points. The two linear loads are displayed in the pilot. We create now load combinations. To access the combination window, in the pilot, right-click on Combination and choose from the context menu Properties. A dialog box opens, allowing to create and to configure the load combinations. Each load case is represented in a combination by its ID number. The ID of each load case is available in the property window. In our case, G1 and Q2. Create two loads combination. Click Add to insert the combination line. Each line has an ID number, 101, 102, etc. Enter the coefficients and the load case ID, 135 for dead loads and 1.5 for live loads, in the corresponding case column. Notice that the combination formula is displayed in the name cell placed on the bottom side of the dialog box. Click Add again to insert a new combination line. Fill in the second line's coefficient cells, one for dead load and one for live load. Click OK to exit the dialog box. To analyze the model, select Analyze from the pilot. The following dialog box appears. Verify option check if the model has errors. The selected action is done together with the automatic generation of the analysis model. Once the analysis model is created, notice the workspace changed. The pilot has switched to the analysis mode. The analysis toolbar is enabled. We create now the mesh of the structure. Click the mesh button in the analysis toolbar. The structure meshing is done automatically, taking into account the default mesh settings. Click the calculation button from the analysis toolbar. The calculation sequence dialog box is displayed again. Select finite element calculation and click OK. The calculation is done automatically. You can view the calculation details in the command line. Once the calculation is completed, the results post-processing phase is enabled. The analysis FEA result toolbar is displayed automatically. In this phase, you can view the results distribution on the model and save post-processing views. We go to result setting and we select forces from the drop-down list. We select MY and case combination, we can select the combination we want to see. In result settings, we go in options and we select values on the diagram to display the values. In the FEM result toolbar, we select MY for the linear element. We select the self-weight combination and we press post-processing. We can change the dimension of the values going to result settings. In settings, you can save the view that will be displayed under post-processing in the pilot. When the results are updated, the analysis icon is black, if not, is red. To have a fast access to graphic results, rather than using the result option dialog box again, you can use the FEM result section in the results toolbar for a fast access to the main result, displacement, forces, stresses for linear elements and or plate elements. In the FEM results section in the result toolbar, select the displacement result type and D result on linear elements from the corresponding drop-down lists. Click the button shown to start the post-processing and to view the model deformation. You can save the post-processing views. Then we show the forces for one of the combinations. In the FEM result section of the result toolbar, select forces result type and F that result on linear element from the corresponding drop-down list and the combination 101. Click post-processing to start the post-processing and to view the shear force diagram. Save the post-processing view. In the FEM result section of the result toolbar, select forces as result type and MY result on linear element. From the drop-down list, select the combination 101. Click post-processing to start the post-processing and to view the moment force diagram. save the post-processing view. Select Generate a new report in the Reports section in the Result toolbar to display the following dialog box. The right side of the Report Generator dialog box contains the items that can be inserted in the calculation report, formatting and editing items, tables, images, text, etc. To configure the report context, we are going to add a cover sheet and create a chapter. In the Document tab of the Report Generator dialog box, select Cover Sheet and click the double arrow to add it to the report content. Select the cover sheet placed in the left part of the window. Right-click, choose from the context menu Properties. A new window is displayed, where it is possible to define the cover sheet contents. Click OK to validate and close the window. In the Document tab of the Report Generator dialog box, select Chapter and double-click to add it to the report content. Rename it Displacement. Go to the Table tab, select Finite Element Analysis, then Result, then Displacement, and then go to Linear Elements and add Displacement of linear elements by elements by clicking the arrow to add the selected table to the report content. We right-click on the element we have added and we select Properties. Select Advanced option, where you can choose to display in the report only the self-weight displacement. Go to the Post-Processing tab. Select the Displacement D1 Post-Processing View and then click the double arrow to add the selected images to the report content. After defining the report contents, click Generate button placed in the Report Generator dialog box. When finished, the viewer application starts and opens the report automatically.